When trying to start as an entrepreneur, one of the first things you have to do these days is social media. Now, being a nobody, it's hard to get on anybody's radar. And you often learn that at a certain point with a business, you have to invest money into advertising, even on the smallest dollar amount, like $10 a week or whatever. You need to invest. At a certain point, you realize it's your business. The more you put into it, the more you can get back. The thing about that is, a lot of ads now in the West, in developed countries, are expensive as hell. These people have caught on that it works in social media, investing in it. Facebook ads, Instagram ads, that sort of thing. They're oversaturated, and most people in those countries are so used to ads all day, every day, on everything, that they just don't click on them. There's no, like, the click-through rate is ridiculous, and it's partly cultural. There are countries that click through at a way higher rate who just aren't as oversaturated with ads. Those are developing countries that are coming online for the first time or who are new users. That period of time will soon fade. It's already near fading. But for the next year or two, there's still a time where, a couple years perhaps beyond that, where countries like India or South Asia will have a much higher click-through rate at a very low cost, because running an ad in London costs 10 times more than running it in Mumbai or outside Mumbai in Delhi. The thing about that is, the second biggest population of English speakers in the world are in India, at least with the fluency to see an ad and understand it. So they're one of the cheapest English speaking communities in the world to target for ads. So if you want a temporary boost to just look like more people are looking at your Facebook page, just throw them over, your ads over to India for a while, run them at very low costs for like 10 bucks, 50 bucks, you can get thousands and thousands of followers and likes. And then you flip it back over to a community where you actually think you'll be selling your products or services or your idea or getting people on board with your cause. And then you can get more users who have better interactions. There's no substitute for real people who care about the cause. The problem is getting to them. If somebody sees a page with like 2 likes, they're not ever going to click on it. Doesn't even matter if they like the title or the description or whatever, if they take a glance at it. They don't even bother with it. They don't even think twice about it. So throwing ads over to South Asia temporarily or some other cheap place for ads that with good click-through, that's worthwhile in the beginning to do, just to boost yourself temporarily. It's very commonplace for developers to do that, or programmers or social media gurus or whatever this bullshit is. The thing about that is, typically they want to be paid to run these ads, and what they do is they throw them over to these sorts of communities, artificially boost your numbers, and then run them through users who are more likely to actually purchase the product, so that they get an immediate result. That's what the idea is, that when you throw them to South Asia, you're trying to look within the first week that your page has numbers. The real interactions, that's what ultimately builds brands. But you have to get past first impressions. And one way to do that is cheap ads in countries where ads go a long ways. Beyond that, there's no shortcuts. Sure. Now, you might have a product that's just as useful to somebody in South Asia who speaks English as in America or Britain. So who's to say that you're not building real customers using that approach? I'm just saying, kind of works for everyone, at least in the short run.